What's up, guys? So this video is going to be on the new proposed tax plan by Biden, and it's the same old thing from both sides. It doesn't matter, you know, Republican or Democrat. They're not really looking out for the little guy, and they're not really looking out for society in that sense. And I'll tell you what I think should be done, and what would be a better solution. And you guys see me post, so capital gains is going to be up there. So how are the rich going to get away from the capital gains? Basically, you just let the stock portfolio grow, and then you could just borrow against it. If you have $1 million or $10 million stock portfolio, and you know it's cash, right? You go to a bank and say, "Yo, I need $1 million," and still go buy whatever the hell you want to buy, and you're not going to pay any taxes. Only when you sell it, most people are just going to wait until a Republican gets in and this gets repealed, like, you know, 10 years down the road, 5 years down the road, or whatever, and then make the moves they're going to make anyways. The surprising thing here is the state and local tax, you know, SALT or whatever they call it, right? State and local tax, that was capped. If you look at the chart, and CSNBC did a really good job on this, like the distribution of people that they play for the deductions, the blue states were ending up paying more in taxes than the red states. So what is this, the deduction and stuff? So basically, state and local, you know, taxes were capped under Trump. So this helped red states because, you know, no offense, but red states are a lot poorer. You got a state like Montana and a state like Kentucky, like property taxes and income are not going to be as high as they are in California and New York. So what happened was, is the people that are doing really well in these states, they weren't getting as big of a deduction on their taxes. Actually, they were having to pay more in, right? And now if they get that removed, they get that repealed, this helps the Democrats or Democratic voters in those Democratic states like California and New York, because they're going to be able to deduct more. It's that simple, and they want that a part of this part of the plan. That's what they're you know, you're pushing for. So it's like, I don't know what the hell people are talking about when they're like, you know, had somebody on the comments say like, "Oh, you got no morals. We know where you stand morally." I'm like, you think I'm a bad person just because I gave my opinion on the George Floyd case? Like, did I think he deserved to die? No, he didn't deserve to freaking die, bro. That's freaking horrible what happened. Do I think that the cop acted, and I've said this 100 times, that the cop act in a way that he deliberately wanted to kill somebody? No. And if you don't realize that, if you think that that cop went to work and all he wanted to do was just kill a black guy, I don't know what to tell you. I don't know where your morals are standing. I don't know where what the hell is going on in your head that you just think that all white people and all cops are evil. What he did was stupid, all right? He handled the whole situation stupid. He should serve jail time, but I don't think he should. I don't think he deserves to serve his whole freaking life, because he didn't intentionally go out saying, "I'm going to kill this guy." Not even in the heat of the moment say, "I'm going to kill this guy." But, you know, whatever. I just had to address that because it sucks to be called like that. I'm giving my opinion. You're getting ridiculed. But you know what? I'm the one that made this page. I'm the one that gave my opinion. And I got to be able to take the heat. So that's totally fine. Moving on to the tax thing, you guys seen me, whoever's been following me for a long time have seen me talk about this stuff, talk about politics. I'm pretty sure you'll come to the conclusion, you'll realize I'm way more progressive and left-leaning, you know, than I am actually freaking right-wing and Trump. It's like, no, bro, I just want common sense laws. And one of the things that really makes me frustrated is, you know, when it comes to the taxes and it comes to actually helping poor people and actually helping people get a chance in this country, nobody actually wants to talk about those things, and they want to disguise it with politics and racism and keep your eye off the ball. I'll tell you why. I'll tell you what I think should be done. It would probably help the majority of Americans actually becoming in a better situation. Number one, it's a lack of access to capital for minorities. When I mean by minority, I meant, let's say economically, you know, like white people and freaking black people and Asian people and Hispanics or whatever. If you're poor, if you're 18 years old and your mom and dad doesn't come from money, and you know, you don't have a rich uncle, you don't have rich friends that will help invest in you, you know, invest in your startup, invest in something for you, you're going to have a lot harder road. Now, do I think in America you'll still be okay compared to other nations? Yes. But that's the number one thing that should be addressed. And I've said it 100 times, 1,000,000 times, and I'll keep saying it. There should be like some type of an angel loan where it says, okay, I don't think you should get it at 18 because you don't know what the hell you're doing at 18. Your brain's not even developed until you're 25. So like, you turn 25 years old, The government should come to you and say, you're a citizen of this country. You've now lived 7 years as an adult. We're going to offer you not a handout, but an opportunity. You could get $50,000 from the government, written, and all the big banks and like apps like SoFi and, you know, all these online banks could have this application. You have a social security number, prove that you paid taxes, prove that you're a citizen of the country. And they'll say, okay, we're going to give you a loan for $50,000. We're going to make it, you know, 40 years at 3% fixed. You take that 50 grand, you do what you need to do. You want to pay off debt? You want to put a down payment on a house? You want to use it to pay off the school debt? You want to start a business? You want to put it in stocks and just don't touch it and whatever? You do whatever you want to do. Then when you turn 35, 10 years later, if you paid on time, you've done the right things, you should get access to 100,000. You know, and now it's like, okay, you're more mature. You've learned from your mistakes. You've paid on time. You get a second chance in this country and you could put that capital to work. It's not going to kill this country at all, because guess what? It's not debt that just disappears. It's debt that's issued that you are going to pay back. You are going to pay it back, right? And it's like just that one change would freaking help so many people that are struggling. It's like common sense, but we don't want to do that. We want to talk about everything else except for things like that. We want to talk about race. We want to talk about this. You can't have a peace of mind if you're worried about how the hell am I going to get a roof over my head? Where's my next meal going to come from? You need some type of stability, and finances, money is not going to make you happy. All right. Having all the money in the world is not going to make you happy, but having money to be able to meet the basic needs, to give you a freaking chance to breathe and think about your life and take a little bit of chances in life on investment opportunities or whatever, that is going to make your life better. That is going to help with mental health. That is going to bring equality. But it's not a handout. It's a loan that you are going to pay back. The second part of that thing is we all get charged, you know, for owning a home, 1% tax in California, at least, right? If you buy a house for $300,000, $500,000, and $500,000 in California, you're roughly paying $5,000 a year as property tax. That's everyone that pays us on a home. So I don't understand, and I've changed my opinion on this a lot over the years. There probably shouldn't be billionaires in this country. Like, I don't think people understand the amount of money that $1 billion is. But you can't just rip it away from them right away and just be like, all right, we're going to go just give it to people that are unproductive with capital. There has to be like a smart way to handle things. And I'll tell you why I have a problem with billionaires. People are like, oh, look at you. You don't want to know. It's like they have too much freaking influence. You have that type of money, you could buy politicians. You could buy policy. We shouldn't want that as a country. That's too much power into the hands of few. So just like we pay property tax, if you really want to do a tax on the rich, then do a tax where you could gather up all their assets. And for rich people, it's not going to be that hard, right? Because they have stocks, they have bonds, they have real estate property, and you can determine the last sell value as the lowest base points for real estate and for boats and yachts and whatever. Add all that junk up and then do it something that is fair. So your first $100 million, you don't get charged nothing, right? Any dollar that you make after $100 million or your net worth after $100 million, you get charged 1%. I mean, that's still a drop in the bucket. And after a billion, if you're a billionaire on paper, 5%. You know, we could talk it out and see what makes sense, because it is kind of ridiculous that certain people have that much power and that much freaking, you know, control. And it does corrupt the system. And it's all done behind the scenes. And it's all done to all these narratives that are going on is divided to make you hate me and me hate you, which I don't hate anyone, by the way. I do not hate anyone in that sense. I respect everyone's opinion. I just disagree. But it gets people fired up. And it's like, we need to come together as a nation, not further apart. And these simple steps right there would probably be a really, really, you know, good way and a good start to do it. And then to finish things off, I think we need a simple tax. This shit is so complicated. There's so many little loopholes. And it's like, everyone's like, what the hell? And the government collects. Guys, if you charge someone 80, 90% in tax, I promise you they're not going to be paying 80, 90% in tax. They are going to figure out a way not to pay that tax. why not do a flat tax, right? Why do corporations get away with it, but individuals don't? So sorry I had to edit this out because I kind of messed up my numbers there. But if you make an income of, you know, less than $500,000, you pay 10% in tax, flat. It doesn't matter if you make $100,000 a year, $200,000 a year, all the way up to $500,000 a year, you just pay your 10%. Every dollar above $500,000, you pay 15% flat. It doesn't matter if you make $1 billion that year or if you make $20 million that year, it doesn't matter. It's 15% flat. You'll get a lot higher collection rate in that way because you wouldn't have that many people trying to fuss and fight and figure out a way to scheme the system. And also, I am 100% for a billionaire tax because I think having that much money is too much power for a small group of people to have this much influence over our lives, which literally means if you have more than $1 billion, you'll pay 5%. So you're forced to sell stock, you're forced to sell assets to get you back under that $1 billion mark, which is still an insane amount of money, but it brings revenue into the system, you know, and it doesn't allow them to have crazy, crazy amounts of power. I would actually want it under 100 because if you have $100 million, if you're worth $100 million, that's great. Any dollar after $100 million, if you paid a 5% tax, dude, sorry, bro, you're still going to be fine. You're going to be living just fine. You're still going to eat great steaks, smoke great cigars, have your fancy sports car, have everything. But the power gets taken away from the rich and the elite, and it would be thrown back into the people because they wouldn't just be able to buy elections and influence things like that with a snap of a finger. So it's like, I don't know, man, it just got to me a little bit fired up because it's like, I genuinely want to see everybody do better. I don't give a shit what color you are. I don't care if what gender you are. I don't care, you know, whatever you want to do. I don't care. More power to you. I want to see you do good. I want to see you be happy. And I don't think that policies on the left and the right are really intended to help the average regular person like me and you, someone who gets up and works 40 hours a week. I don't think these policies are there to help us at all. I think it's there just to get us in this little circle and living our lives until we die. And while we're talking about it, how can we also address the student loan crisis with all these young kids that got so much debt that they're not even going to be able to get out of in a lifetime, some of them? Very simple. Just like we build out the banks, we build out the kids, but not in the way that you're thinking where we just forgive everything. No, we give them 40-year fixed loans done through the Federal Reserve. Federal Reserve uses all the other banks, like mentioned before. You got $100,000, $200,000 in student loan. Okay, 40-year loans, 3% interest, and get government the hell out of lending, you know, to these institutions and saying, oh, we'll back you no matter what. We'll pay whatever you want. No, hell no. Make it fair. Make it competitive. And watch these schools' prices drop. And if you do want to forgive everything, then make the schools pay for it. Let's see if the Democrats will step up to the plate and do that, as schools are one of the biggest donors to the Democratic Party. So Harvard and Yale, all your hundreds and billions of dollars of endowments that you got, liquidate it off and pay off the student loans and pay off the loans of the kids that you took advantage of. I don't know, man. This is just my thoughts and my opinions.